From a perspective of, you know, working around SSH, there's always a spectrum of, do I have best practices or do I look at a problem that I don't know how I'm going to fix? Ultimately, it comes down to best practice. There's very specific regulations around best practice when it comes to SSH because it's a big mess when you look at it. But a true key governance system is one of the pieces that is very influential for risk and compliance and for a security team in general. You need to be able to have key governance on a system and understand what your keys are being used for and when they're being rotated, and a life cycle ultimately for termination of employees or people with keys. They need to be automatically removed. The risk of no governance is, in essence, you'll have keys that leave the organization and you're not aware of it. You have keys that are coming in from external parties. If you don't have key governance, you have no idea what's going on in your network. They can pivot. There's other risks from there where they could exploit man-in-the-middle attacks and things like that. With key governance and understanding, you can minimize the risk from external vulnerabilities, essentially exploits. Then it moves into a true inventory, right? You need to have a true inventory of your entire organization. And when I say organization, it's all machine identities that comprise that organization, and we need to be able to map them and show where all the integral pieces are connecting to be able to do a successful rotation. And where the true inventory truly comes into place is you need to make that map. You need to align all these processes with what you have internally, because if you don't know a private key has access to 250,000 public keys and you go to rotate that, you could have just broken the biggest application for the bank. At whatever vertical you're in, their application, you could have just broken it and you have to go reset it. Well, what a true inventory does for us is it gives us the ability to work with the application owners. It gives us the ability to show them, this is your key set, what should we do with it and when? When's the best time to rotate? So knowing how they all map up in the true inventory and having all your hosts within the Venafi system allows us to make sure there's no outages for specific processes. The third portion is to enforce policy. You need to be able to enforce policy, so you're creating, you know, compliant keys. And this falls into the risk and compliance completely, because they know after every rotation, the compliance is going to be met because you're enforcing the policy set by Venafi. From a perspective of standards, there's compliance standards, and you have to have specific algorithms, specific formats and stuff in place per NIST, per FISMA, you know, HIPAA to whichever, BICEP, all of the different standards out there that policy has to abide by. What we do and what every customer should be thinking of is creating that policy that they need to enforce into all of their business areas and their IT infrastructure. And we enable the policy that can show where they're out of policy from a perspective of the lowest level, an algorithm, right? They might have weak ciphers or weak keys. We can take and fix them with a rotation, right? And we tell every customer that, you know, most of the policy sets that you're doing, you can actually rotate. And now from this point going forward, the rotations are happening and policy is being, now you're compliant. But to enforce policy, you have to meet with these business areas. You have to tell them when's a good time for the rotation to become compliant. And that is the hardest part, to enforce policy. It's one thing to create it and show where we're out of policy, but now it's adoption. When can we actually rotate these so you have compliant keys? If you enforce policy, if you have policy that you're abiding to, you can point out all the risks in an SSH implementation, you know, across the organization. And then last is continuous monitoring. So we'll set scheduled jobs to monitor these systems. We'll have continuous monitoring on self-service. We'll have continuous monitoring on all keys generated outside of our system, so we can report, notify, and do the things that we're supposed to be doing for that system. If you think of out of band practice. And when I call it out of band, I'm meaning if I'm creating keys on a server for myself, I should be technically going through a specific workflow process. But when it comes to continuous monitoring, we want to be monitoring everything outside of that. So as keys are created out of band, I know about it, and I can put processes in place to delete these keys and tell them to go through the specific portals that you need to, or have their manager talk to the administrator and say, you're not doing this correctly. You need to go through X, Y, and Z to access your keys, which is a self-service portal, much like Venafi has. You need to have the monitor around it so you know if people are using them out of band or creating them out of band. So when I look at it from a perspective of continuous monitoring, we know that we're going to go out there and find that real inventory, right? And find everything. But now how do I monitor that entire inventory through its life cycle? And that's where continuous monitoring comes into place. We can schedule it daily. We can schedule it hourly. Whatever it is, we need to be knowing about the key changes that are happening and the utilization of the keys, because then we can start creating a roadmap of what's going to happen with these keys and when we can actually remove them. And ultimately, when the three things are done, or the four things are done, you bring in your business areas, and they have to comprise sets of specific standards that they're going to follow because they're signing up to the risk and compliance and security team's objectives. Security is there to do compliance and tell people where they're out of compliance, but the business areas that created the problem and have the key sprawl, they're the ones that have to clean up their mess. So we're not trying to put any extra work on the security teams in general or security operations. We're going to put the work back onto the people that created the problem from the get-go.